David?
Good morning, everyone. So good to see you. Thank you for wearing your masks today. We know that we're in a time of uncertainty still with the Delta variant, and we're trying to be as safe and as careful as we can, so thank you for that. Have several announcements. I want to just say welcome to Elon Community Church, United Church of Christ. As we come into these late days of August, we know that there's a lot going on. You've probably already noticed the increased activity on campus. The students have moved in, and they're getting ready to start classes this next week, so things are going to be a lot busier. They're going back to a more normal schedule, and we are hoping that as such, we will be able to do some things more normally as within any kind of new ways of operating we're going to continue to do. You notice that the hymnals have returned to your seats, and you can feel free to use them. You have two options today in the bulletin. You either have the number, you can look it up and sing out of the hymnal, or you can just use the words that are in the bulletin. So whatever works out best for you, we want to be able to let you do that as well. If you are visiting with us for the first time, we would love to get information from you, and it's written on this insert right here. You can put it in the offering plate on your way out. We want to get a chance to say thank you and welcome to you. If you're online and visiting, we hope that you'll send us an email at elancommunitychurch@gmail.com and let us know that you're here with us. We would love to be able to say thank you for being here. And like the folks who are doing their addresses, one of the things we're realizing is that even though we're trying to move into back to a more normal direction, that there's still a lot more we're dependent on in terms of our distance. And that distance is something that we can't always take for granted because we're not positive we're getting a hold of everyone. One of the things we found is that on our database, we still have some things that need to be changed. In other words, some people's phone numbers have changed or emails have changed, or sometimes even their address has changed. And we want to get all of that information. So we are endeavoring to send out information to you. You saw it this week, and we're going to be sending out a congregation-wide mailing, giving everyone an opportunity to update all of their information. And there's a couple important reasons for that. First one is that you know we're getting ready to do our photo directory, and I know most of you have signed up, and I want to thank you. If you haven't, there's still an opportunity to sign up. It's for August 31st and September 1st. If we got 20 more people, we don't think we're going to get that many, we could open up another day. But many people have decided to submit photographs, and that is perfectly fine as well. just so that it looks like you and so people can recognize you when, you know, you could put George Clooney in there, but I've thought about it in a couple of days, but that wouldn't help you to recognize me during the week. So please put something in that people can see, and we're more than happy to have as many of those kinds of additions because we really want to have a point in time directory. You do not have to be a member. You're just a part of the church at this time. We want people to be able to know you. And so many people say, I can then put faces and names together, and it's really helpful. So I hope that everyone will take part in that. But I hope you'll also do that address thing and take it seriously. Just make sure that we have all of your most current information. And you can either do it electronically, or we're going to give you the ability to mail it back if you're not a person. And most of those people we're probably not talking to right now. But I just wanted to make sure you knew that that was what was happening. On the page that is also on the insert, you're going to notice, in addition to the photo director, you're going to see that next Sunday, we've been kind of just letting the summer be a time of self-study, and we've given you lots of different things to look at and to be involved in, but we're going to have a gathering a week from today in the evening. It'll start at 7 p.m. We're going to be in the Community Life Center. We're going to get a chance to use our brand new projector, and you're going to be very impressed, and everything is ready to go. We are going to be watching a documentary together. It is called True Justice, Bryan Stevenson's Fight for Equality. Many of you would know him as the name behind the movie Just Mercy. And some of you saw that Just Mercy was one of the movies you could have watched over the summer. Just Mercy, the movie, lasts about 2 hours and 20 minutes, and we just felt that was too long. This documentary is shorter and more clear about who Bryan Stevenson is and the projects that are going on. One of the things that he has helped to help create is allowing us to understand more about the truth of how people have been treated over the years. It's called the Remembrance Project. We're actually going to be doing a fundraiser on Sunday night as well, or at least offering to you the chance to be able to help with the remembrance work that's happening in Alamance County. There were actually three individuals that they have documented who were lynched in Alamance County, and we are wanting to remember them and recognize them, and so we're taking part in a project that does cost a little bit of money, and we're going to be raising money throughout the community, and we're going to be doing that. By the way, speaking of that, you're allowed, and we really hope they'll be vaccinated, but we hope that you'll invite others, not just in our church, to come to the movie. And we'll still have plenty of room to spread out and enjoy the time together. We have popcorn. We have all kinds of opportunities to discuss, and we will be doing that in a safe way. So I hope you'll be a part of that. Just before that event, though, next Sunday, our youth will be doing their special party. They're going to be coming together to celebrate the beginning of a new year and back to school. And so we hope that they will want to be a part of that. Just remember that starts this coming up Sunday. Let's see, at 5 p.m. I didn't see the time. And it will be at 5 p.m. So that's going to be before the movie time. So I hope that some of the youth may want to be a part of our movie night as well. I hope they don't have too much homework after the first week. So, and we know that school starts for our children tomorrow. We know our teachers are back. We want to be mindful of all of them as well. One more small announcement, and that is earlier this summer we asked for people to bring your shoes. We're collecting shoes for another ministry that is using them, and we thought we had been done, but it sounds like they're still collecting shoes through September. So if you have some shoes that are not too well worn and you'd like to share them with someone else, please bring them to the church, and we'll have them down in the we'll have a box down in the atrium. You can leave your shoes there as well. I think I've shared most everything that needs to be shared. There's others that you can read, but also I hope you will see online. And I hope that we, as we now prepare for worship, that we can come together as a community of action, a community of love, and a community of faith. So in that light, let us now stand together as we are ready to worship by sharing in the call to worship together. We have come to feast on the living bread, that we might minister to the world's hungers.
Blessed are those who hunger for righteousness. Let us now share praise and worship for all who can be filled and see you, O God, as the source of life and peace. Come now, Almighty God, help us your name to loud. Our songs we raise, ruler all glorious, o'er all victorious. Come and reign over us, Ancient of Days. Come now, incarnate Word, by heaven and witness bear, in there attend. Come and your people bless, and give your word success. Grant us your holiness, Savior and Come, Holy Comforter, your sacred witness bear. In this glad hour, your grace to us impart. Now rule in every heart, never from us depart, Spirit of power. To you, great one in three, eternal praises be. Forevermore, your sovereign majesty, may we in glory see, and to eternity love and adore.
Together our prayer of invocation. O God,
we have no life apart from you. We do not come here to eat bread that fills us for a day. Rather, we come to be nourished by you, and that the love you have for us fills us for a lifetime. May this food strengthen our discipleship. Grant that it will renew in us our commitment to proclaiming the gospel of peace through our ministries of peace and justice. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen.
Wave peace to one another. Peace be with you. You may be seated. Our first scripture lesson this morning is from the book of Ephesians, the 6th chapter, verses 10 through 20. Hear these words. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against the enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. Stand, therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, that with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am the ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly as I must speak. And through this scripture, God is still speaking, and we are listening. The kids that are here with their backpacks, will you come sit on the front porch? And Joy, you're welcome to come. I don't know if you brought your backpack, but I'd love to have you up here today. All right. You want to put your backpacks in front of you, and we'll bless those in a minute. Nice backpacks this morning. Joy, did you start school this week? Yeah, I thought you did. Cool. Well, I wanted to share with you online and the children that are here this morning and youth that are here this morning a book. It's getting ready to start school for most of you. Joy started this week, and all of you start tomorrow, and we have teachers out here that start tomorrow. And I bought this book sometime over the pandemic, and I just thought it really spoke to me about this school year. And it's a book called I Promise, and it's by LeBron James. Does anybody know who LeBron James is? Yeah. But it's a really good book with a really good message for you as you go back to school today. It says, I promise to work hard to do what's right, to be a leader in the game of life. I promise to go to school and read as much as I can to follow the rules and respect the game plan. I promise to run full court and show up each time, to get right back and let my magic shine. I promise to open and try new things and enjoy the happy that change can bring. Are you ready to try new things? Some of you try middle school for the first time, right? I promise to wear a big smile and use kindness when I speak, to remain strong yet humble with every win and defeat. I promise to ask for help whenever I need it, to reach for my star even when I can't see it. I promise to ask questions and find answers, to believe in next time and second chances. That's really important. I promise to use my voice and stand up for what's right, and when things get tough, to keep up the fight. I promise to stand tall, rise up, and give all that I've got, to throw the alley-oop and lift others on the spot. I promise to respect my elders and teachers and peers the same, to leave new places better than I came. I promise to stay true, keep my head up, and never give up, no matter what. I promise to dream big and love bigger and to be a team player and a winner. I promise to cross bridges and break down walls and to rise with the sun and learn from the falls. I promise to be courageous and to be free and to strive with greatness. I promise just to be me. And I think that that just has such a good message. And you know, who's with you all the way this week? God is with you. And we promise to God that we're going to be kind and loving and just that God is always with us in the good days and the bad. We have some bad days when it comes to school. We have some good days. But God promises, too, to be with you all the way. Now, if you want to line your book bags up, and I don't know if David can angle the cameras or if they can show their book bags, we're going to do a little blessing of the backpacks right now. And those of you that might be online, you can get your backpacks here, and we're getting ready to do a blessing over them. So let's say a prayer about that. Lord God, bless these backpacks and the children and the youth who carry them and use them as they begin another year of school. Give them peace when they feel nervous, focus when they feel distracted, energy when they feel tired. Open their minds to the lessons that they will learn. Help them to make friends that will build one another up and be friends to those who need them. Guide them in making good choices as they grow in wisdom and maturity. Be with their parents as they are tasked with guiding them each day on this unusual journey of doing school this year. Be ever present with them in their classroom, wherever they may be, at home and in class. And may they feel your loving care in all they do. And also, oh Lord, bless the teaching, the ministry of teaching that these teachers are going through this year. Be with their teachers every step of the way. And we all say, in Jesus' name, amen. All right, I think I got some smarties under here. Because it's smart to come to church. I got just enough. Let Pastor Sharon get her mask back on. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. And here you go. Good job. You can go back to your seats.
As we go back, we know that there's some uncertainties and some worries, and we want to be mindful of that as well. And I just want to say thank you to the children that are here today, helping us to celebrate the backpacks. And we know that there are many of you. We hope that you will take that blessing to heart this week as you start school. And all of our many, many teachers, we just want to say we're with you in this process as well. Well, we find ourselves back in the Gospel of John in chapter 6 as we are reading, I believe this is the last time, for the bread of life. And this is quite a symbol. This is probably one of the more interesting readings as we go through this, 56 through 69. You'll notice that the Bibles have been put back in the pews if anybody wants to follow along. We didn't put page numbers yet. But we do want to let you know that those are there. We're kind of moving from a BYOB, where you don't have to bring your own Bible anymore. But you're always welcome to, so remember that. Listen now as I read. This is Jesus speaking now. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them, just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father. So whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever. He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This is a hard teaching. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you there are some who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." And that is the ending, even though it's a very abrupt ending to our gospel reading today. Let us be in prayer together. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Well, as we come into this season of education, as we come closer to the end of this season that we know of as summer, or at least that summer vacation time, we are still finding ourselves in the midst of this metaphor that is shared in John about Jesus being the bread of life, and so much so that we have this almost literal idea of eating flesh. And wow, that's not easy to hear, is it? And I almost feel bad when I'm sitting with children in a room and read that, because children do tend to be more literal and might say, "Does the Bible really say that?" So of course we're going to clear up right away that this is not a literal. In fact, what's so interesting about it is that it talks about this in the most literal sense of flesh and blood, and then it turns around and says, there's nothing in the flesh, it's all in the spirit. So which are we to believe? And yet the disciples, those who were following Jesus, heard this, and it was difficult. It was a hard teaching. And they weren't sure what to do about it. They weren't sure how to react to it. And so it even says that some left. And Jesus then even challenged his 12 and said, "Do you wish to leave?" This is not easy to hear at this time. We want to hear good things. We want to hear that Jesus provides for us. Now, there's good news within it in the sense that as we follow Jesus, there seems to be this promise of being fed forever, being filled forever, not just for a day, not just in a temporary time or place. And yet, the words are so difficult to hear. One would wonder why this was placed in the gospel. One would wonder why this is something that we have to deal with. I can't help but think about hard teachings. We actually live in a world today of, it seems at times, only hard teachings or difficult teachings, difficult things to understand and to grow upon. Of course, in the Bible, they didn't have 24-hour news. They didn't have a world that was so small that everybody knew what was going on even minutes after it was taking place. We live in a world today in which We're receiving all kinds of information, probably more information than we care to get at times. But it is right at our fingertips. It is right in our eyes and in our ears, in our surroundings. Yes, you can go out of your way not to listen. And some have learned to listen to only certain kinds of information. Because if we listen to the information that only bolsters what we already believe, it's a lot safer. But I think it would be easy for each of us to admit that this difficult teaching here is easy compared to some of the difficult teachings we receive even now. We have now started to witness, even in this summer, now maybe is it the news trying to show us in a different way, or is it really hard facts? Seems to be that there is a true sense that the warming of our planet is now having some beginnings of some real ramifications for us, with fires, with flooding, with heat, creating death, creating problems, creating immigration, starting just really at the beginning. And the temperatures are slowly going up on average. And we know that if it goes up further, there's going to be even graver consequences. We talk about it. We teach about it. And yet we don't always listen. Or we don't want to follow. We have been pummeled this week by the bad news of what is going on in Afghanistan. And many of us, knowing that this war has been going on for 20 years, how many times did we think about it? But yet now it is right there before us, questioning what it is that we're doing and how we're doing it. And again, we're looking at it from a national perspective, not a faith perspective, but we're thinking about it from a sense of how do we care for people. It was just last summer when we had murders of African-American men and women. And we were on protest lines trying to react to that as well. A difficult teaching. We're being told all of the time things that we really don't want to hear. We really ultimately wish that we could ultimately get away from some of this and look at good news and see that as people of the good news, that we can live within that good news. I feel your pain. I'm there as well. There are times at which I wish I didn't have to do the things that I want to, that I have to do. It seems that we spend more time mitigating, doing things that are things, well, again, the pandemic. How many of us wanted to put masks back on? How many of us came in here months ago celebrating that we had had the vaccine? The vaccine seemed to be working, and we could now get away from some of the isolation that we felt and spend time together, starting to gather again. We have a plan in September to get back more and more to a normal idea. Could you imagine with 150 or more people in this room? So far, we're getting more and more, but we're not even there yet. And yet, we wonder, are we going to do that? Or is this pandemic going to go on for years? And we're going to be having to do things differently for years. How do we take this in? How do we receive it? How do we endure it? Well, it seems that the scripture has some of these ideals that helps us to think about it from the perspective of faith, from the perspective of understanding that with God in our midst, there are ways that we can be people that we can be. Today in Ephesians, we have that most common story of putting on the whole armor of God. I want you to know that's not an original story. In fact, it's used in a lot of different perspectives over the years and even in ancient times. But this notion of how it is addressed, what is that armor, what is it to protect us, is not a way of avoiding. It's a way of addressing. But knowing that we ultimately, in faith, will not be defeated if we understand that God is near. If we understand that our faithful presence allows us to keep going, does that mean that there won't be hard and very bad times? No. We know that that will happen. We know that we don't have some kind of an invisible shield around us to keep us completely protected as much as we would like it. We're coming up on the 20th anniversary of 9/11. 20 years ago, when the Twin Towers collapsed. In fact, on September 8th, there's going to be an event here in our sanctuary, because in the Elon community, the first place people came when that bombing took place in this area was this sanctuary. They wanted to come for prayer and reflection. And we'll do the same on September 8th. And we'll be reminded that 20 years later, where do we find ourselves? And who are we? Difficult teachings. Hard teachings. What does it all mean? Does it mean that we give up? Does God truly allow us to put on some kind of armor that will give to us a sense that we can protect ourselves, or at the very least, know who we are in the midst of it? And think about how those pieces of armor are described. Faith, spirit, preparing ourselves to share peace, and truth. Wow, what a big one. In a world in which we live, where truth seems to be loose, we wonder, can we find that truth together? Maybe it seems that coming to church or being a person of faith is harder than ever. My answer to you today is that I don't have a guarantee. I have an invitation. As a messenger of the good news, as a messenger of peace, as an ambassador of Christ, we have, as a community, a strength that helps us to rely on something more than just what we hear and experience and see. As I shared with my Bible study class earlier today, isn't it interesting that everyone had a better plan for Afghanistan this last week? Boy, did we screw it up. Yeah, well, we're good at that. One of the things we've learned is that we are going to screw things up. One of the things that we're always going to hear, though, is that if we think there's always a better answer, then we are not seeking the truth. We have parents in our own school district that are coming to school board meetings wanting to ban certain teachings in our schools. I want to remind you that 100 years ago, they were doing the same thing. But then it was for evolution. Do you remember the Scopes monkey trials? Well, we weren't there, hopefully. But you know, this goes around and around. And you know, we might need to think of this like an ongoing sense of not just confrontation, but living within a world, living within a framework in which we will never have it all figured out, nor will we ever be able to say we're completely protected or completely free of bad or difficult news. But as Peter shares, Christ, you have the words of eternal life. Where else can we turn? It is in the midst of that very foundational idea in each of our hearts, in each of our minds, that allows us to stand the line, to rise up and act, to be agents of peace and justice, to allow people to see that in the midst of all the things that can tear us down, we can still be strong. Not defensive, but a strength that comes through love and grace. But I'm going to be here today to tell you it is not easy. And we already know many have walked away. Walked away from a church that is filled with hypocrisy, that thinks it has all the answers, when we are a community that struggles in love together. And when we show that sense of our humanness along with that sense of faith, I believe we have something so much stronger than all of the answers. We have something so much more powerful than the greatest armor and the greatest arms. We have God by our side. And as we follow and as we share and live out, even in difficult times, we can find love, share love, and we can receive the peace that God has given us. That's what you're invited to every day. As a community of faith, that's who we are. That's why we will act even in the smallest ways and even in the biggest ways, each and every day. I promise. We've had a summer with LeBron James and Britney Spears, so I hope you understand that even other people are telling us these words. I promise to follow in love and to know that Christ is with me and that I am in Christ. How will we do the same? Amen and amen. I wanted to share that date of September 8th with you. September 11th is actually a Saturday, and we will be ringing the bells that day to remember. We hope that people will want to do acts of service or be a part of something to help us realize that we can move beyond. But September 8th is a special time, and I invite you to come be a part of that community event here in the sanctuary. It starts at, I believe it's 7 o'clock, but I'm going to make sure that you have, it's going to be in the evening. It's going to be a Wednesday evening. I'm pretty sure it's 7 o'clock, but I'll get that to you for sure. So. Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But I hope that we see that we have opportunities, like the movie event that we have together. We have opportunities to come together and grow together. We have ways of sharing. We have wonderful opportunities that sometimes are as simple as our farmer's market. I don't have many of you been able to take advantage of our farmer's market, but there is more produce out there now than we have ever had in the past. It is good stuff, and I hope that you will help us share the word that when we are buying local, we are doing something important and good. All these simple things that we can do are the simple joys of being a community of faith. Coming together to minister to the needs of our community and letting people know that they're hungry, that need to be fed, people who are lonely, who need to be reached, families that need our attention. And we do that. And we have opportunities and ways to do that. We must be brave. We must be courageous. I just want to thank the courage and the dedication of all of the teachers in this congregation who will once again come to church, come to school on Monday morning and face what they must and teach in the midst of all the ways that politics and everything else throws you around. And I pray that our children, as they courageously go and learn, that there are some wonderful things that can come from that. That is the joys that we share. And it was a great joy last week having our music camp. I'm still wearing my mask from music camp. And what a wonderful experience that was. We have great opportunities to be in ministry in ways that we still have not even seen. I hope that we will remember that as we come into this time of joys and concerns. I know that there are many joys that you may be sharing. And I hope that you will be able to share them with each other. I hope that we know that in the midst of our concerns, that we are here for one another. When we got word about Jackie McHenry losing her father, we instantly got that out to you. Many of you haven't had a chance to meet Jackie, but she's a precious part of this community. And more than likely, if there's a service, will be held in this church. And I hope that we'll come out and support her. And it's Jackie's birthday today. Thank you. I didn't see that. Happy birthday, Jackie. So all of these things are ways that we share together. We know that there are persons who are anticipating still other surgeries and other procedures. We know that there are people who are suffering from medical maladies and issues. We pray that you will be there. We don't have exact names today. We know that there are many in our community that we'll bring up and we'll pray for, but let us now go to God, knowing that we can pray for all of these folks, for the situations we do see on the news, all of those things that we sometimes make us feel helpless. Let's bring them to prayer. Let's remember that God can help us to at least find ways to see who we will be in the midst of this. So let us now turn to God in prayer. To feel your presence in the midst of all of the slings and arrows that are out there, oh God, all of the things that are coming at us, sometimes so fast, for all of the situations in our own life that come and surprise us, that come in unexpected moments, for all of the things that we must experience, oh God, we know that you are acting in our lives, and we pray, oh God, that you will be with us to help us to recognize it and to see that with you we can find a way forward. We can be your people in the midst of hard times as well as good. In the midst of the joys that we share of being a community of faith, amongst the individual joys that we are feeling in our hearts and we are sharing right now with you, we pray, oh God, that you will help remind us that we will be with those ongoing concerns that are not only just around the world, the true suffering that people are experiencing. We are called in our deep down in our hearts to try to be about something different. But we know that there are those individual things that we must face, those family situations that we must face, those situations with friends and around our local communities that we must face. We pray, oh God, that you will help be with us in the midst of it all. As we find ourselves in the midst of all of these things, we look to you, oh God, as we pray now, as we lift up those things in our own life, as we share those concerns that weigh down our shoulders and our hearts even now. Be with us in this moment of prayer. In the midst of the hard teachings and the difficult words and the difficult moments, We turn to you, O God, and we pray all of these things in your name through your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray when he said, Our
Father,
who art
in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power,
and the glory
forever. Amen. In this time of our recognition that we have much to offer as well, let us meditate upon this time with the wonderful gifts that we have to share and that we will receive even now.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Sing your praises, alleluia. Praise God above you, heavenly host. And Holy Ghost, alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Let us pray. All good gifts around us come from you, O God. You have given us life and a new life in Christ, and you have given us gifts. So we offer our gifts that we may be gifts to one another, even as Jesus so taught and lived. Amen.
Now the bread of life, Savior, to me. As you once broke the loaves beside the sea, beyond the sacred page, I seek you, Lord. My spirit for you, O living Word. Bless now the truth, dear Christ, to me, to me. As you once blessed the bread by Galilee, then shall all bondage cease, all shackles fall, and I shall find my peace, my all in all.
Go forth in a world in need. Go forth recognizing our brokenness, but understanding our wholeness that comes through God. Go forth being ambassadors of peace. Go forth knowing that God is with you in all that you do and in all that we are. As we go forth in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.